Hey guys, so in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do the Logo Loop High Tech template, how to use it essentially. So I'm going to go through a simple process right now. It's going to be first locating it. I'll just start from scratch. The way you go through it is you go through our Stadium Drive, right? Then you go to Stadium Content. Everyone has access to Stadium Content, but I'm using it through the Stadium Media account. So just go to Stadium Content, then you're gonna go to Logos. Nope, not Logos, my bad. Graphics, and then Templates, and then Logo Loop, and then Adobe. I know, so much work. And then High Tech Reveal. So there's a lot of mess going on over here. You got Gunner, PISD, High Tech. Yeah, so to keep everything organized, what you want to do every time you want to make a new logo is you want to make a copy of any project, any one of these, and then you want to duplicate them, right? And then you want to name it whatever school you're doing. So right now, Logan told me that I have to do Whitesboro, so I'll name it Whites. Wait, no, there's no space. Boro. And then I'll just click enter. And there you go. So what you want to do, you just can double click it. And then while that's loading, you could go ahead and find the logo that you're looking for. Most likely it will be in Logos. So let's see if we have Whitesboro. Oh, it looks like we don't have Whitesboro. So we got to Google it now. And then when you save it, make sure it's saved to Logos, right? And then make sure you name it properly, right? Whitesboro, Boro. I keep doing this. And then let's go back here. So right now we're at the template, right? We're at Gunner's template. So what we want to do is we want to go to Logo, and then go double click one more inside, and then this is the Gunner logo. So delete it, and then you can drag it from here if you have to, or drag it from the file. But I prefer from this because it's, you know, more work. I'm looking at it at a quarter. If it's something as simple as a logo, you can view it at full without any kind of problems. So, and you want to get rid of the whites without getting rid of the white inside. There's a way to do this. It's really easy. You just do auto trace, layer, then auto trace. And then you do this. Make sure it's alpha. Make sure it doesn't say apply to a new layer. You can preview it. The preview actually messed up. Alpha does black. I actually forgot about this. So maybe do red. Would red work? No. Okay. Green? Kind of. Blue? Luminance? All right, let's try luminance. There you go. Luminance worked. So first things first, turn every one of them to add so you see what you're getting rid of. So basically, start deleting the masks like one by one. Oh, look. I already did it. So this should be fine. So we found the mask that covered the outline, and we deleted it, and now it's transparent, basically. Looks like I was being lazy with naming this properly. Here we go, logo. All right, and then we go to main, and then look, it's changed. But the colors don't match, and the text doesn't match. Well, the text is easy. You just go to text, and then you do Whitesboro. Whitesboro, what is their team? Whitesboro Bear. Whoa, let me make sure this is on auto. Whitesboro Bear Cats. Yeah, there you go. So, okay, boom. Now, all is left is the color. And then also the room right here. It's probably a little bad. So how do you change the color? Well, the color is going to be a little weird. You just got to go to blur. Blur is the main composition. And then you're going to look for this thing called change colors. I know, so hard. So what I like doing instead of like going through this, I just like using the pen tool. Everyone does. Probably not for the logo. I'll just make the wording a little different. And then for the color around it, I'll use that color. This color again, and then the background, I like to use the same color but like a little bit more dark, not a little bit, like a lot darker, because you want some contrast, right? So like that much darker, And then that much darker. See, now it's glowing. And then the last thing left is the text. The text, it's a little hard to find, but should be like, oh, look, text here. Huh? Not that hard to find. Move a little up. Looks like it's too big. You can go back to this text. I always like doing this, just decreasing it like this. It's a little easier for the whole thing. And then boom, look at you. You finished everything. It's nice and it's full and it doesn't look half bad. And if the logo looks bad, well, that's not on you because you didn't do anything to make the logo look this bad. Literally, the logo I grabbed is like tiny, so it doesn't matter because the screen is 720 p, so I mean it's whatever. And then you just do add to render queue, or not add to render queue, add to, well, it depends on what kind of video you're doing. I always use encoder, but encoder is way better. And then make sure you save it to the proper place. Most likely you're gonna save it to pending media upload, but you know what, I'll do that. I'll do it there anyways. What is this called? Whitesboro. Whitesboro. Boom. And make sure everything looks good, and then press OK, and then you just play and render it. And that should be it. That's how you use this template. Shouldn't be too hard navigating through it. That's it.